Hello. I'm going to be speaking directly into the camera during my presentation. However, got to look at my notes tonight, and I will have some PowerPoint items as well. Yes, my friends, there is something very strange in the neighborhood. Something very weird going on. And who are you going to call? Well, unfortunately, the Ghostbusters can't help us with this one. Very funny, great movie, but what I'm going to be talking to you tonight for the next 15 minutes is anything but funny. Hi, my name's Tom Hagedorn. I want to invite you on a thrill ride through history. Put your seatbelt on. There's gonna have to be some pretty good prep time before we get on that ride through history, though. So let's get started. So the opening line to the Communist Manifesto from Marx and Engels in 1848, it begins like this: "A specter, that's a ghost, is haunting Europe, the specter of communism." Well, my friends, it's no longer just Europe 173 years later. The specter was successful in taking over Russia, China, North Korea, Cuba, Nicaragua, a number of South American countries over time at different times. And the same goes for Africa and obviously Eastern Europe as well. But there are many aspects of Marxism that are already thriving and actually controlling most of the cultural elements of the United States right now. And I'm going to read some things. These are direct quotes from the Communist Manifesto. They're real clear about their plan. The bourgeois family, that's the middle class and maybe upper middle class, will vanish as a matter of course when its complement, in other words, when the middle class itself vanishes. Both will vanish with the vanishing of capital. Communists desire to introduce and legally and openly legalize a system of free love. The first step in the revolution by the working class is to raise the proletariat, the poor, to the position of ruling class, that's the middle class and the upper classes, in order to win the battle of democracy. So Marx envisioned starting with democracy and then going to totalitarian communism from there. Once that's done, the manifesto lays out 10 steps. In other words, once they take control, here's their 10 steps. Some of them: the abolition of property, a heavy progressive or graduated income tax, we brought that in 1912, centralization of credit in a national bank with state capital, and an exclusive monopoly. That's the Federal Reserve in 1913. Now it's working hand in glove with the US Treasury. Centralization, that was 1913. Centralization of the means of communication, 2021 and 2020, right? Political power is merely the organized power of one class for oppressing another. So much for politics and democracy. They just look at it as a weapon to oppress their enemies. The concluding paragraph says, "The communists openly declare that their ends can be attained only by the forcible overthrow of all existing conditions, social conditions." Engels also said later on, after Marx died, Engels said that he was so thankful for the anarchists because they were a big part of helping them. They were going to be a big part of implementing their plan. Antifa is anarchists. They are not anti-fascists. They are fascists who are anarchists. Does this sound far-fetched? Gosh, I don't think so. I think I've already outlined several instances where Marxism already is in place in the United States, in their own words. How'd this happen? It happened slowly, inexorably, right under our noses. As we slept, we were boiled like a frog. I'm next going to give a brief outline of time. I'm going to go through about 10 data points. I'm only going to give you one as an example. I'm going to start with the 1700s and the French philosophers. They declared essentially there was no God and that reason was their God. They were so smart they could figure things out. They didn't need God. They could create a utopia right here on Earth with their brains. So what they came up with was implemented in the French Revolution in 1789. Their watchword was liberty, equality. I'll repeat that, equality, fraternity. That led to murder, mass murder. It led to a reign of terror that closed many churches and murdered many people, especially religious people. And then I'm going to go on and take us all the way up to the 2020 election at that point. I hope that I hope you leave my presentation tonight very afraid, because our time is running out. If darkness falls, if the Marxists take over, it could be years, it will be years, perhaps decades, perhaps generations before freedom returns. That's the history of communism. Once they take over, they got a stronghold that's very hard to break. Is that the future you want for your children, your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren? We have 1 year left, folks. The red states must hold firm and must resist. We have a lot of Republicans who have been bought out by big money, and they're not fighting this. We need to drain the swamp, whether it's Columbus, Frankfurt, or Indianapolis. We got to get to work, folks. This is a call to action. We've only got 1 year. If we wait till right before the next election, it's too late.